vibrate. We don't want to disrupt the speakers. I know we got some special music ringtones, so that might get Mr. Dacosta for dancing if you hear your phone ring, right? All right. So what we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and get started. I'm so excited. Anybody excited to be here?
Yeah!
Great, great, great. Hey, I want to ask, how many people were in that special meeting last night? Anybody get a chance to get a special meeting last night? All right. Guys, man, that meeting was fire. Okay? So we're going to go ahead and get started. My name is Eric Lee. I'm going to start you right now and walk through Wisconsin going too. And we at the baddest place on the planet here in Planet Parkland, right?
Yes, sir.
All right, so today, anybody want to know how to build a local business?
Yes,
sir. Who wants to learn how to build a national business? That's what we're here for. So I'm going to get out the way. I'm going to introduce this guy. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the number one income earner in the whole UK. Give him a round of applause. Number 13. Income earner in the entire company out of 16,000 reps. International teams in our company, all right? And also, what I love about this guy, he has a personality, guys. He has a personality. Now, he's a 3-star director, meaning that he's helping over 500 families in our company. I want you to all stand to your feet and welcome Mr. David Dacosta.
Really excited to be here. I think the first thing we have to do, I mean, we have to understand that this is a very, very special occasion. I would love a big round of applause, firstly for Mr. Donald Bradley.
Okay.
You see, before we even go into talking about how to build an international business, Donald Bradley didn't need to go into the UK for myself. People like Andre Sinclair, Ricardo, he didn't need to build an international business. It wasn't so much about just the money, it was about the relationships built. Understand? So this is a situation that doesn't really come about often, where a big business decision has been made based on relationships, someone of integrity doing something to help people that he started something with that he wanted to finish. So that's why a big round of applause for Donald Bradley again and the corporate staff. God, this is a blessing, and this is our blessing, and it's our time to really pass this blessing on, not just around the UK, but around the world, around Atlanta, around Baltimore, around the Philippines soon, around France. This is a blessing that we want to share internationally, hence why we're going to talk about how to build an international business. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. anybody want to build an international business? Yes,
sir.
I want you to turn to the person on your left and say, go global. Turn to the person on your right and say, get money. So we're going to talk about going global and getting money today. So the first and most important question we need to really ask today is, why would I want to build an international business? Why would I want to build an international business? Why not stay where I am? See, I'm going to give you some of my reasons as to why building an international business. You see, having an international business is fun and sexy. Anybody agree? There's nothing more sexy than waking up 4 a.m, get onto Zoom and Skype calls with people from different countries. It is a very exciting feeling. Traveling around the world, meeting new people, amazing foods, amazing cultures. You know, I mean, there's nothing more sexy than earning currencies that you don't even know how to work out. But you can still buy stuff with them, right? There's nothing more sexy than trying food and speaking to people that you have no idea what they're talking about. And you're listening, you're like,
yeah.
I'm going to show you me traveling around the world. This is me presenting. I don't even know where this is. That's me underwater somewhere. I mean, this is me building an international business, see, branding myself. And just, you know, I believe that's in Thailand. It's representing the brand. It's actually been all over the world. That's me presenting on stage in Atlanta. Here's me in Florida, Millionaire's Row, with my business partners, Eric Hawkins, and we were just about to get onto a cruise. Before that, I was speaking in Florida in an event, and then before that, speaking in Atlanta, being able to speak literally many places. But very recently, you know, something very exciting happened. Myself and Eileen Ross were able to be the first people to open up Jamaica, right? We need a round of applause for Eileen Ross, 4-star director. I was blown away. I was blown away. Anyone seen the footage of that? When she did the travel part of the presentation, I was blown away. I wanted to sign up again. Absolutely beautiful. And to be able to, I mean, I never saw myself traveling the world 3 years ago. If you told me I'd be presenting the first event in this company, a legacy company, the first time ever in Jamaica, I would have said, you've been drinking. But it was absolutely amazing. You see, like I said, building an international business is fun and sexy. Me and Eileen not only went to go to Jamaica to meet some amazing people, help change some amazing lives, but have an amazing time. You see, Jamaica is probably the most vibrant, crazy place in the world. Absolutely amazing people, amazing culture. You know, it's one of the most copied, impersonated cultures in the world. When you go to Jamaica, the internet start thinking, talking like this man. Everyone wants to be Jamaican. And it's so contagious. We had an amazing time. Here's a quick video. What it's like, you know, just me, Eileen, just having an amazing time around the culture, the environment. We were just walking around. I mean, we finished our presentation. It must have been like 10, 11 p.m. their time at night. Just walking around looking for food. There's a little video of what it's like having a fun international business.
Original Jamaica dish.
Where is that?
Ackee and selfish.
Ackee and selfish. You're going to get some ackee and selfish, Eileen?
For who?
Ackee and selfish.
Ackee and what?
Ackee and saltfish. It's traditional Jamaican dish.
Yes, ackee and codfish.
Ackee and codfish. Yeah, we're saying it wrong.
You'll be alright.
Yeah, it's alright.
No, I'm not giving the fried chicken.
No, you're not gonna. No, this is what it is.
David Dacosta, aka Mr. Go Travel, out here in Montego Bay, Jamaica. You know, just soaking up the life of a local. We don't look like locals.
Not at all.
Not at all.
Like really?
Yeah.
Like really?
Trying to cover my scars. I'm inactive bronze. First freestyle on credit hold.
You bronze builder, you.
I'm a bronze builder, me.
Absolutely amazing time we had in Jamaica, Montego Bay, Jamaica. And Eileen was able to go back again, do an event in Kingston and again in Montego Bay, Jamaica. And it's an amazing feeling going to a country for the first time and helping new people get started in the business. So again, why would I want to build an international business? Here's me, you know, fitting in with the culture, trying. That's how the room looked before we actually got started. It was scary, I'm not gonna lie. Traveling, I mean, $3,000 worth of travel to get to Jamaica, have a room empty like that, just faith and hope. But we know we've got a very good business, right?
Yes.
We know we've got a business that will fill up a room in Atlanta, Georgia, fill up a room in Montego Bay, Jamaica, fill up a room anywhere around the world, right? Anywhere around the planet, because we've got a very special business. So building an international business, the first thing you need to understand, I mean, there is a sacrifice involved. I'm not gonna say it's all gonna be peaches and cream. Some of you know, we had a very special guest speaker, last night, the best person ever touched the microphone in the industry of network marketing, in fact, hands down. And some of you know who I'm talking about. And he was saying, there's an investment needed. There is an investment. You don't open up an international market, go to another country for free. There's an investment. And it can be sometimes a very big financial investment you have to be prepared to make. But the rewards are very worth it. And I'm gonna be talking about, when we start this presentation, when we start getting into this presentation, I wanna be talking about, obviously, some of the objections, some of the pitfalls that you could fall into, how to overcome them, what to do to not even ever get there, so you can build not just an international business, but a successful, fun, and exciting, profitable international business. That's my goal here today. You see, I was here in the USA, Atlanta, Georgia convention. Anybody here from Atlanta?
Woo!
Yeah.
That's my favorite place in the world. I'm moving to your country. I'm moving to your city, the state. I'm going to be there. Busy Bees, Soul Food, that's just me. But I was here at the Atlanta convention and I was speaking on the same topic, building an international business. And I was going over, you know, some of the basics, but now I really want to dive into the practicality. What do I do practically to build an international business? So I'm going to show you, obviously, I think I've got a clip. End of Jamaican.
Gentlemen, I have to take my first ever Jamaican selfie. So on the count of three and say, Planet Marketing Jamaica. 1, 2, 3. Planet Marketing Jamaica!
That's the feeling of excitement, of exuberation when you build an international business. It really is the best feeling in the world. I've obviously presented many places all over the UK, all over the States. That was one of the most touching moments, to go to a totally new market. And it's the connection you have with someone who traveled seven hours to get to that event in Jamaica, to say, you know what, I came because I saw something. And then it's a responsibility for you. If you go to a new market, you start something going, you need to make sure that you're consistent. You need to make sure that you, it's not just about, hey, guest speaker, look at me, and then run away. No, you started something and you need to finish it. You need to be there. It needs to be care. And we're going to be talking about that as well. So, again, why would I want to build an international business? Having an international business is fun and sexy. It's a beautiful thing. An international business means your income is more protected from issues that arise in your country or local area. Now, what do I mean by that? I mean, if you just have a local business, and we're going to be talking about building just in the States as well, because some people are only going to build in one state. For example, many of you in Atlanta, Georgia, we understand the heartbeat of Planet Marketing is Atlanta, Georgia. That's where the founder's from. That's where the biggest event, biggest weekly event in the Wyndham in Atlanta, Georgia happens. And that's the heartbeat. And some people are only going to build in Atlanta because it's convenient. It makes a lot of sense, right? All my friends and family around me, my prospects around me, the local meeting is only 20 minutes down the road that way. And that would normally make sense, but having an international business means your income is more protected from issues that arise in your country or local area. What if you have your direct in training, right? You've got 50 people in your team and they're all in Atlanta, Georgia. Would that be a good or bad thing? Good or bad thing? It's not a bad thing. I mean, it's good to be direct in training, that's good money. But it could be a better situation, right? It could be maybe 10 of them over here, 2 of them over here, 7 of them over there. And of course, as you start growing, you want to start growing out of your comfort zone, out of your local demographic. Let me go over some reasons. Now, I think that's New Orleans. I mean, there was a horrible disaster in New Orleans not too long ago, right? And now let's just say I'm a director in training and I have 50 active members all in New Orleans. Just all in New Orleans, all my friends. Maybe some came from a previous company, you know, prospects I met down the road, and we're just all in New Orleans. And God forbid, a horrible disaster like that happens. What happens? No electricity. No one's thinking about the local meeting, right? Can I call up to get off credit hold? And now my team, if the disaster's big enough and it stays there long enough, now my numbers are just dropping. Now I'm calling someone to say, oh, you need to get back active. No, I've got no house. There's priorities in life. What are you calling me for? Get that active, how? With what telephone? So there's things that happen, and again, obviously, I'm not saying obviously there's going to always be natural disasters, but it can be anything. Anybody know where that is? Something happened recently, right? Is that I-85, is that right? It didn't seem like big news in the UK until I saw it pop up on Facebook. I was like, wow, this is a big deal. Was it a big deal? Is it a big deal, right? Yeah. Now again, I don't know obviously how the highways work in Atlanta, but I'm guessing maybe you can or can't get to the local meeting through that at the time, or there's probably a lot of traffic, right? Now let's just say again, if it was super crazy and maybe happening in two main highways and it's hard to even get around, you can't even get to see your prospects, you can't go to training, you can't go to the local event, and you don't know how long that road is going to be locked off for, right? What if that road is, they say, okay, you know, yeah, it's a structural ground moving, and this main highway is going to be locked off until 2018. Problem, right? Because your team's in Atlanta, and it made sense because the local meeting's there, Don Bradley's there, but you're now hindering your income because all your income comes from Atlanta, Georgia, when it could come from other places. Now, natural disaster is horrible, and we don't like to obviously talk about it, but there is one thing that can be even more dangerous than natural disaster. More dangerous to your country than natural disaster. Now, I'm not here to talk politics. I'm not saying Donald Trump is bad for your country. I'm not saying he's good for your country. I'm using him as an example because obviously he's very controversial. So if I show a picture of him, the first thing you go, oh wow. So I'm not saying, I'm not talking bad about Donald Trump. I was in his hotel the other day, it's very nice. Now, what I'm saying is government. I'm not talking about Donald Trump, I'm talking about government, politics. See, you guys have Trump, but we have Brexit, right?
That's right.
I mean, and again, not talking about Trump, but on the news, you see tabs of different topics. You have the sports news, you have the weather news, you have the international business news, you have the technology news. And first time in my life, you see Trump. He has his own column about in the news. Sky News in the UK, one of the biggest channels we have in the UK, he has his own column. So there's a lot of controversy around the current government in the USA. Now, that can be good or bad for your business in planet marketing. And I've experienced it. See, when myself and Andre Sinclair, we got started in this opportunity, let me try to put it in perspective. You get $50, right? You get $50 for a direct commission. Yeah? $50. Now, with myself and Andre Sinclair, we got started in this amazing business. In terms of the currency, when you get your $50, for us, it was £32. Right? I mean, you guys roughly know pounds, dollars. Because of, not Trump, government, in our country, Brexit, things happened. Today, when you get that $50 direct commission, myself and Andre today, whereas when we started, we got £32. Today, we earn £40. Based on government, right? The government decided to do some things, and it affected me and Andre's pockets. In a good way, right?
That's right.
So, think about that. And what if Andre Sinclair gets 10 personal business partners? Based on government, that's affected his income, his family, right? Could go the other way, couldn't it? See, the pound is a crazy thing, because if our business was just local in the UK, that would have affected us very badly. But because we earn commission from the USA, and the currency conversion based on government, we're very blessed, it affects us in a positive way. But we're not waiting to say, oh, what if the government does something bad for the UK and our income starts dropping? See, Andre Sinclair understands that his family, Donald Bradley told me once, it doesn't matter who's in the White House, it matters who's in your house. And Andre Sinclair understands that he's not waiting for the government to do something crazy and his income to start dropping. He's gonna make sure he's got incomes coming in from all other sources, right? And that's very, very important. What about this? Now I'm not saying this is anybody's income, it's definitely not mine. Imagine that, does that look nice? $2,000 a month from USA, right? £150 a month from England. €300 a month from France. And that's actually a very small amount of money. You're Jamaican, that's what? $4.
Jamaican dollars is very, very small.
I should have thought about that. You see, earning currency that you don't understand. You go to the bank and you say, how much can I buy with this? $3,000 a month from Jamaica. That's literally like $4. That's not even a team bonus. But that's how your business should look. You should be looking to earn income that can pay rent, pay for your car note, pay for food from different countries. That's when you're building an international business. So how do I build an international business? I'm gonna give you the answer right here, right now. Does anybody know how? Anybody can shout out, any ideas? How do I build an international business?
Building
relationships, social media. Anyone else? Traveling more? Anyone else? How do I build an international business?
Open your mouth and start talking to as many people as you can.
Open your mouth, start talking to as many people as you can. That's a good one.
Ask who do you know?
Who do you know? We're getting closer, we're getting very close. There's the answer. You build locally and start asking questions. See, I don't know anybody in France, I don't know anybody in Jamaica, I don't know anybody maybe in Atlanta, Georgia, but I know any people around me. So to build an international business, you first build locally. See, if you haven't even built locally, you're not gonna be able to branch out, especially if you don't know people in other places. And just like the gentleman said, asking questions. Derek, hey Derek, oh wow man, I'm so excited. We've just launched my company in Jamaica. Do you know anybody in Jamaica? Do you know anybody in Jamaica? Do you know anybody in Florida? Do you know anybody in London, England? My company's just open up there. We're looking for some very sharp people to launch this project over there. Who do you know in this area, this area, this area? And you see, people like to obviously feel popular, important. If you know somebody in Florida, and I ask you, do you know someone in Florida? If you know somebody in Paris, and I ask you, do you know someone in Paris? It's pretty much impossible for you to say, to hide them away and say, no, I don't know anyone in Paris. What do you want to do to them? No. They're going to be involved and say, yeah, I know someone in Paris. Yeah, I know somebody in Jamaica. Yeah, I think I know someone in Atlanta. And people will, and when I start building a local team, if I have a team of just one person, it's hard for me to really build international because that one person probably knows just as much people as I do. Start building locally, really start building locally, and asking every member, hey, you know we just launched in the UK, you know we're actually getting the ITA program in England, right? And that's going to be a big deal. I'm going to really focus obviously on England because I really want you guys to understand, not in a rude way, but the pound is still stronger than the dollar. And the way we travel in England, I mean, many of you guys go from state to state. You go from, you know, New York to Miami Beach, and that's called a holiday, vacation, right? We can't do that. You see, the same distance it is to go from, you know, from Miami to Atlanta. That's our country. You've gone up and down like five times. So we can't go. I mean, it's like going from, it's like going from New York to Newark and saying you're on a holiday. It's not gonna work, right? So we travel outside the country. So there's a lot of money. If you're someone who books travel, you know, you earn a little commission on an international flight, that's a lot more than a domestic flight. You may not even know, you know, I don't believe you earn a commission on a domestic flight. But in the UK, we do not fly in the same country. The reason is because if this is the country, if this is the UK, that's the length of it, and here's a plane, it's like half the length of the country. So if you get onto the plane and walk to the end of the plane, you're halfway across the country. So there's no domestic flights, hardly in the UK. If we get on a plane in the UK, I understand we're going international, and there's a lot of money attached to these international flights. So you want to be building in the UK especially, because we're a very small place, or a very powerful place, with a strong country, so you want to be build in the UK. I'm going to really help you guys to build in my country. Does anybody want to build in my country?
Yeah.
Anybody want to make some pounds?
Yeah.
I'm going to help you do that. So build locally and ask questions. Hey, who do you know in England? Who do you know in Paris? Who do you know in Jamaica? So 7 degrees of separation. You see, I mean, I think some of you may have seen the film. Some of you may believe this. I don't even know if I really believe this, but it's quite interesting that everybody in the world is connected through 7 people. You see, I'll give you an example. Let me think of something. So let's just say I'm building my business. I'm building my business and I find Derek Reynolds in Atlanta, Georgia, who finds Susan in who lives in Buckhead, who finds Jones, who lives in Charlotte, North Carolina, who finds Robert, who also lives in Charlotte, North Carolina, who finds Anne, who lives in Houston, Texas, who finds Marcia, who lives in Jamaica, who has an uncle called Lucy. Was an uncle called Leon. Yeah, has an uncle called Leon, who lives in Paris, who has a nephew called Andre Sinclair, who lives in London, England, who became a one-star director in your team. Now, you missed out on Andre Sinclair. That's not a true story, by the way. But you missed out on Andre Sinclair. But again, who do you know? 7 degrees of separation. Who do you know? You know somebody in this country, you know someone in the same country, you know someone in that state, you know someone in the same state, you know someone in Jamaica, you know someone in London, UK, who is willing to do what it takes to become a one-star director, the second highest income earner in the whole of the UK and in Europe, the second biggest team in our country. Who do you know? And it comes again from building locally and asking those questions. So, hey, do you know anyone in England or the Caribbean or France? Our company's expanding in those areas. We're looking for a few sharp people to help us launch our home-based travel agency in those markets. So very simple, keep asking questions. The people will confidently, they will confidently tell you, yes, I know somebody in Paris. And you know, it's a thing that can work. You know, the indirect approach. Hey, I know this is not for you. I know you're not interested in making lots of money and changing your life, but who do you know? You know, almost disrespectful. Disrespectful in that I love using an indirect approach. It annoys people. I know you don't want to make any money. I see you at the job center. I mean, but you can talk to anybody. They don't even have to be one of your business partners that you built with locally. Just go in to ask a prospect. I said, hey man, my company's just moved into London, England. We're looking for a few shop people to help us open the first ever, and this is for you guys, when you are talking to your prospects who do live in the UK, understand that the ITA program, I mean, I think a quick round of applause for James for our, a round of applause for James for our. Program is phenomenal. It is the best in the world. And in the UK, in Europe, we can just say Europe, it is the only fully legal and compliant, affordable home-based travel business, which gives you the backing of a 25-year-old company, which I promise you, this is, I don't know the best way to describe it for you guys, people in England are gonna eat that product. They are going to eat it. When they fully see it, when you show it to them properly, oh man. It's gonna be a hot Sunday. They're gonna hunt you down. They're gonna hunt you down to get into your business. I promise you. It is. Remember, because we travel, we're all fake travel agents anyway. We're booking for our honeymoons and not in the UK. We travel so much. There's so many international flights and it's very expensive to have that. Oh, they're gonna hunt you down. So keep asking those questions. And what we've got going on in the UK is a big deal. So you can go to a prospect and say, hey, don't just disregard them. Hey, do you know anybody in London, England? We're about to open the first ever home-based travel agency in Europe. It's going to be such a big deal. I'm just trying to connect with a few shop people in London, England, a few shop people in Paris. Do you know anybody? They're going to be like, what about me? Is it in the US or is it in Atlanta? No, of course, yeah. Yeah, but I didn't think you would be interested in earning more than 6-figure income and obviously being able to earn commission back on your travels because your Facebook doesn't, you know. But who do you know? The indirect approach can be very effective. So that's how to build deep in other markets. But what about personally sponsoring international business partners? Obviously, in terms of asking who do you know, that's not obviously direct because you know somebody, in London, England, for example. But that's not your direct business partner. And of course, you understand that 50% match of someone in England is exciting. And of course, that travel commission, 10% of somebody. Find me a travel agent in London, England, who normally books in the region of $100,000 on a 1-year calendar. But they're now understanding that 3-hour commute to work and that 3-hour commute back is kind of annoying. And maybe working from their bedroom around their children because they have a skill set already, they're qualified, but they've been giving their boss most of that commission that they've been booking. So that laptop, Wi-Fi and baby around them just booking travel because they know what they're doing from home under the umbrella of Intelli Travel that's giving them even so much more reach out to different suppliers and travel consortiums around the world. It's kind of an attractive place to be. And that's that travel agent working from home mom or working from home dad is going to do what they do anyway, booking $100,000 worth of travel commissions. You're going to earn that 10%. Exciting, right? Yeah. So who do you know and that's going to grow your team deep, but what about growing your team wide internationally? Facebook is your friend. Anybody like Facebook here?
Yeah.
I've been able to make nearly $80,000, nearly about a year or so, $80,000 in about 1 year, just through Facebook. Facebook is my best friend. I love Facebook. Literally, I'm not saying to only stick on one platform of social media, but it's really powerful. It's really amazing. So social media and the internet is key. So I didn't even ask. I've got 1 hour, yeah? 1 hour. Say again? 90 minutes. Okay, I need to slow down.
1 hour.
1 hour. We got 30 minutes to go to this class.
30 minutes to go, yeah?
We got 30 minutes to each class, so it's an hour.
Okay. 1 hour, right? So we're nearly halfway through. Okay. Nothing less, my last slide. I'm just gonna dance all around. Social media and the internet is key. If you really want to build an international business, you've got to master social media, you've got to get better. If you are not fluent on social media, learn how to use Facebook at least. So I'm not even gonna go into obviously all the other methods. I'm not going to go into all the other methods in terms of, you know, There's so many ways you can build online. I'm just going to focus on Facebook. And if you're not so fluent with social media, don't go and try and learn them all and try and find people all over from LinkedIn. Just focus on one and become a master of it. Because if I can make $80,000 on Facebook alone, and I'm very savvy when it comes to social media and the internet, but I don't even haven't even branched out yet to other platforms. I'm just on Facebook for now. Because, I mean, the income from Facebook, if I master it, I can make billions, right? So, I mean, it's okay, but I'll be gradually branching out. But if you're new to it, spend some time on Facebook. And the reason why I say Facebook, because it's the most simple, but most powerful way to build internationally. Then we're going to talk about how we do that. Start connecting with other people in other countries. I'm being consistent. See, I talked to Ricardo, one of my number one business partners in the UK, and I'll say to him, I'll say to his business partner, Risha, so many of my business partners in the UK, you need to really just be, you know, just speaking to people in different countries. Type in Atlanta. Who do you know in Atlanta? Just really be speaking to people. Go to groups. Atlanta backpackers, Atlanta travel lovers, London travelers, London travel pros, whatever the thing is, just start speaking, start connecting with other people in other countries and really be consistent. I'm going to give you some of my tips now. It's Facebook. And I know some of you guys are laughing, you probably know what I'm about to say next, yeah? I hate my job. So this is your homework. I mean, you go to your Facebook, and I'm giving you my top secrets, man. This is one of the things that really helped me build international. I hate my job. And I think, no, this is not my top secret. See, he's looking at me. I call this guy the general for a reason. This guy is the general of the UK. This is his. I'm so glad, because I would have got beaten up on the stage. Andre Sinclair was pointing to me. See, I get to learn from my business partners. There's no upline, downline team, it's family. And if you're open-minded, you've got open heart, open ears, you can learn. And this has helped me make a lot of money, so thank you, bro. It's helped me make a lot of money from my bedroom in other countries and currencies. I type in, after learning from tutelage, from Andre Sinclair, one star director, I hit my job. You type that into Facebook. Now, Facebook is going to recognize anything that people are saying. And it's always about, when you fast scroll down, if I can show you all of it, roughly 80,000 hits, whether it's a group, people speaking, personal people speaking, a bunch of people, a page. There's a lot of people out there that, right, hate their job, right? What does that mean? That means they're looking for something else. And they wouldn't say that if they weren't really serious about that. I mean, they're saying it because, you know, they genuinely hate their job. So, there's a lot of people from the UK that hate their job. I'm just saying. There's a lot of people from Baltimore that hate their job. There's a lot of people from Jamaica that hate their job. And if you are willing to, you know, reach out, be consistent, start speaking to people on a daily basis, you're going to find some people that are looking for something different. See, this is how the conversation goes. I type in, I'm from Atlanta, I wish I was. I'm from Atlanta. I'm going to type in. Sounds good, right? Atlanta. I'm learning. One day. We'll make it happen. I'm from Atlanta, and I type in, I hate my job, right? And someone from London, England is going to pop up. So what's your name?
Jeff.
Jeff, sorry, I forgot you. I know you, but I'm stage fright, man. I'm actually sad. So I'm going to say, hey, Jeff. No, you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to, you know, drop a message to Jeff, and I'll see him pop up on Facebook. Hey, Jeff, how's it going? I just saw on my Facebook you said you hate your job. What is your company do? Jeff says, oh, well, I'm a bus driver. You know, I hate the hours. I don't get to see my children. Sitting there in this bus is getting fat. I just hate it. So, hey, Jeff, well, I get to work from home in the travel industry. We get paid weekly and monthly. I try and get that in as quick as possible to get someone's attention. We get paid weekly and monthly to help other people with their travel, to help people, you know, go into international business, etc., blah, blah, blah. It might not be for you, but it might be something you want to have a look at. I mean, we've got many positions available, we're hiring. Do you have 5-10 minutes to watch a quick video? Now, it's very hard for Jeff to say, no, I'm fine. Don't need you. just put it all over Facebook, one of the biggest social media platforms in the world, that you hate your job. So that means you hate your job. So that means you don't like the way you earn income. That means you are probably looking for something else. Unless you hate your job, you just want to stay there, right? So, and that's something you can do. Now, what about for the people that book travel? Okay, so I'm just giving you some examples. I hate my job with a passion. I covered it. That person's in London, England. I'm not going to give you the Facebook name because I wouldn't prospect them. So I cracked it right there. There's like a lot of people out there that are saying what you need to be here for. See, I mean, so many times you're chasing people that are pretending that they're comfortable. I don't need your business. I don't need a residual income. I'm happy making $12 an hour. There's some people out there that are, no, I need residual income. I do not like my boss. I hate my job. Help me. Help me. Help me. Please, help me. There's a lot of people out there that need your help. And Facebook will help you find some people. That's why I like Facebook very much. I mean, I speak to people every day. And one thing I do, and I teach my team to do, I'm gonna give you guys a secret that you may genuinely not know. Network marketing, it's a predominantly American thing, right? Would that be fair to say? Now, for myself, Ricardo, Carla, Andre, we're in the UK. We associate success, success, especially network marketing, with Americans. So your accent, your American lovely accent, we associate it with wealth, with success in network marketing. If you have an American accent, that probably means you have a down line of 2,000 to 5,000, right? Now, I know on the other side, you guys like our accent, I've heard from a few people. I mean, I believe you guys associate our accent, you know, posh and nice and classy, but if we can use our accents to really benefit our business. For example, I would tell Ricardo, hey Ricardo, so actually Ricardo's got an amazing Spanish accent. He's Cuban, so maybe I mean he's Andre. See, Andre's got a British accent. So I'll say Andre would he would type to someone first on Facebook, on his laptop, right? On his computer, type to Jeff and say, hey, and just say hey. This is what I personally do myself, this is me. I say hey. And obviously I've said hey on my laptop, my computer, right? So it's also gonna pop up on my mobile phone, right? Because I can't really send a voice note from my computer, but I can on my mobile phone. And I want to just find him on my phone. So instantly he pops up. I'll just say hey. But then the next thing I'm gonna say is not gonna be any typing, I'm gonna talk. I want you to hear my accent. You see, especially when can I say when talking to the opposite sex, it helps, right? I'm just saying, so if I say hey, I mean I'm not gonna try and impress you with my accent. We call. So I'm gonna say, hey Jeff, how's it going? I'm gonna do my best British accent. Hi Jeff! Hello! That's really bad. But I want you to hear, firstly, I want you to hear that I'm not fake. I'm not a fake spam account. I'm a real person. I'm excited. I want you to hear the passion in my voice. Hey Jeff, how's it going? I'm just looking to connect with a few people in the USA. I see you live in Atlanta. Wow, my business is just booming around the world. I'm actually looking to come to Atlanta in September. I just want to find out a bit more about yourself. What is your company doing? I'm looking for some sharp people that want to help me launch one of the best home-based travel agencies in the USA, blah, blah, blah. You know, just have a conversation so you can hear the passion, the excitement in my voice. You can hear that from London, England. And just that alone, I probably have a bit more now credibility to someone who inbox you the same thing from Atlanta. Would that be fair to say? He's like, wow, I have a friend in London now. I have a business partner in the UK. And it's kind of exciting, and vice versa. I'll be like, wow, I'm talking to somebody in America. Wow, all my days I've got a friend in Charlotte, North Carolina. Wow, I've never been there, but I've got a business partner there, which is quite exciting. So use your accent. In the UK, we associate your American accent with success. Use it. And it works both ways. Obviously, you like our accent, we love yours too. Maybe you didn't know. If you shoot a message to someone in London, England, say, hey, how's it going? I'm trying to put my land. Hey, how's it going? My name is Mike from Atlanta. We're looking for some sharp people in the UK. That's really bad. I apologize if I offended anybody. Thank you. So, and they're going to be like, oh, wow, Atlanta, Georgia, wow, their accent, wow. They must have a downline of 17,000. I need to join this business. By golly. So use your accent. Don't just type to people. Build that instant relationship as quick as possible. And that's just one of my tips there. So Facebook is your friend. Social media and the internet is key. You need to use it. If you have no laptop, no internet, you are going to struggle to build an international business. Get a laptop, get some internet. If you're not fluent on social media, learn how to use Facebook. At least start there. Start connecting with people in other countries and be consistent. Master your international calendar. Does anybody know we have an international calendar in your back office?
Yes.
You do? You have, anybody seen this before?
Yes.
Who really uses their calendar? Really uses their calendar. You see, for me to have an international business, there's dates. I need to know my calendar. For example, I would fly out to Florida, and then from Florida, I'll head over to Atlanta for maybe for a convention. Florida, I'm making sure, if I'm in Florida, I'm there for a reason. I'm recruiting your friends and family in Florida. I'm going to every local meeting, any home event that's there in Florida. Then I'm going to head over to Atlanta for maybe, you know, Eagle Weekend or a big event, convention. And after that, anywhere I am, I'm making sure, if I'm going to be in this state, the other day I was in Charlotte, North Carolina. Is there something going on there? And I'm going to use my international calendar to make sure that when I touch down somewhere where Planet Marketing is active, if I'm within thousands of meters of an event, I'm going to be going there. So, and again, I'm going to talk quickly on building domestically as well. Because of course, yes, building around the world is very important, but you still want to build in different states. You see, if something goes wrong in Atlanta, maybe it's something like the I-85, but you've got so many people, San Diego is very far away, they're not affected. You can, if something slows you down in Atlanta, you can now start looking at San Diego or London, England. So really understand what's going on. What's going on in the different areas where you live, and make sure that, look at the date. So let's say that's the 11th. Now, of course, if there's an event, these events going on the 11th, it's a bit too late now for me to be calling a prospect to say, quickly get to this meeting. It's too late, you missed it. You should be looking in advance on your calendar. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to start looking at least the 13th, 14th, and get people prepared, building a bit of a rapport, speaking to people beforehand, and saying, hey, there's something coming up that I need you to attend. Now, you may want to take a picture of this. This is me now. Open up the floodgates, because as the ITA program does come to the UK, I really want you guys to build in my country, and I'm going to help you individually, whatever you need. Obviously, you got some of you may have me on Facebook. Obviously, I haven't got too much time, but reach out and be quick with it so that I've got somebody, and try and find out where they live in the UK. I know it's hard to understand, where bits are, but ask them, where in the UK do you live? And they're going to tell you, and that makes me be able to help them quicker. It may be a phone call, it may be a three-way call, it may be, here's the right video, it may be they can actually get to one of our events. Now, we've got two main flagship events. Obviously, this is the main one in London, and we are branching out to all the four corners of London, and that's every Friday. And Birmingham, so not Birmingham, Alabama, Birmingham, England. So you might want to take a picture of that. I'm going to tell you why. Those are the addresses of our two main flagship events in the UK. Now, there's a bit of psychology behind this. A little bit of psychology is, you see, who lives in Atlanta? Show of hands. So what's your name again? Cynthia. So Cynthia, you live in Atlanta, Georgia, right? I want to go to the Coca-Cola factory. Yeah. How far is that from your house? 20 minutes from your house, right? See, so we. Good job. I really believe. I looked into it. There's a bit of psychology in asking somebody how far is something from your house. See, if you live in that place, you are bold and confident. You know the demographic, you know the distances in where you live. Because if you live there for 5, 10, 20 years, and you don't know how far this is down your road, you're gonna feel embarrassed, right? So you're going to conflict. Say, I know this is around the corner there. Yeah, that's where I live. That's my town. Yeah, you just go down there. You want to take this train. So people are going to be confidently telling you exactly where something is. So you're now trying to prospect people in London, England, right? And you want to. ITA is about to launch there in the next 60 odd days, 60 to 90 days. It's going to be fire. You're going to see me hit 4-star real quick, right? It's going to be fine. You can help me. You can help yourselves by really building and getting the buzz in the UK. This is a big deal. It's a huge deal. I'm not in a disrespectful way. It may be this program, the ITA program, may be more loved in the UK than in the USA, based on where we travel. It's a very big deal. And I promise you guys, if you guys really take what I'm saying on board, you guys will birth directors all over the UK. You guys will be earning pounds in your sleep. Right? Who wants to earn pounds in their sleep? Serious pounds in their sleep. I really want to help you guys because I believe, I'm not selfish, there's more than enough people in the UK for me to hit 9-star. If you guys all hit 9-star too. It's in 5-10 years, this is going to be a big deal. A very big deal. This is Facebook for travel, day one. Mark Zuckerberg's got $100 just to buy a few servers, and you invested $100 with him, and what did it turn into be? So, you've taken a picture of both of them. Now you're trying to prospect someone in London, England. You're going to shoot them a message. You've been talking, build a bit of rapport. Maybe even before you actually tell them about your business. You're talking, building the rapport. And that's good to do that as well. As many voices as possible. Try not to type too much, let them hear you. You're going to shoot them a message. Hey Cynthia. You're in London, England, right? Which one of these addresses is closer to you? Which one of these addresses is closer to where you live? You know, I'm from America, I don't really understand, the demographic, how the country is. I know you guys are the same size as Baltimore, it's tiny. I know you guys are the same length as an airplane, but which one of these two addresses is closer to you? Do you think they're gonna say, oh, I can't tell you that, that's confidential. Getting all up in my business. No, they're gonna happily tell you, the Birmingham's quite far, I'm in Southeast London. I'm in Manchester, but yeah, Birmingham's probably a lot more closer than London. They're going to tell you. So now, they're going to say, which one is closer, red or blue? The red or blue pill? And now you know which one. That's London, that's where I'm from, South East London, and that's Birmingham. So now you know which one you want to be inviting them to. And if you now were to... Now, obviously, you're prospecting them, you're going to shoot them a flyer for whether it's the London or the Birmingham event. And we are going to be, obviously, building to multiple places. You will see it on my Facebook, you'll see it start popping out, you'll see it in the back office. This Birmingham event is going to soon be in the back office. It's now turning weekly. Me and Andre, as soon as we touch down, we're going to be there in Birmingham. It's now turning weekly, so you're going to be seeing events. So keep in mind your calendar. I've told Leanne to specifically put our UK British event in your American calendar specifically for you guys, because I know you may not click the UK flag because you guys don't care much about us. Appreciate that. So you guys may not click the UK flag to see what's going on in the UK, but now it's easier because you just have one on the USA flag, and when you're looking on Friday, you see Baltimore, you see New Jersey, you see San Diego, you see London, England, right? Makes it easier, right? So you're going to be seeing a lot of, it's going to say, London or Birmingham, UK, so okay, I need to get my people there. And the person already said, yeah, that's not too far from you. And the Jews in Croydon, yeah, that's just 20 minutes down the road. Now, if it's within an hour, they can get there. And just so you can understand, in the UK, you guys are willing to drive 7 hours, and that's just a normal journey, because it's a very big place. So I'm going to give you a tip. In the UK, we're lazy. So if the distance for them to get to where they are, to one of their addresses, is 2+ hours, I'm just going to be honest, they probably wouldn't do that journey. So you might have to find another way. If you find the right person, me, Andre, we will make that journey for the right thing. If you can, prospect them the right way, they'll make that journey. But if you're just talking to a normal person who hasn't really got, the heart of a director yet, they're not going to... So you guys will easily travel 2 hours to get to a briefing, right? That's just nothing. We're in America in 2 hours. You don't even move on a map if you travel 2 hours. Like, you're in the same place. You guys will have to travel 2 to 5 hours to get to a briefing. They won't. They won't. You can find out if they're the right person, but I'm just being honest with you. So it's a totally different... these are the things that you need to understand now. Understand the demographics. So quickly move on. Where is it hot? Now, in the UK, it's not hot. It's cold. I'm not talking about temperature here. I'm talking about what market is popping right now. So in the States, what market, I mean, you guys tell me, what market in USA is really taking off right now?
Texas.
Ohio, Baltimore, Maryland. Let me just write these down, I'm gonna recruit your friends. So, New York, yes, definitely New York. New York is, so where it's hot. So it would make sense for you to try and reach out and to really try and build in where it's hot. I'm probably not gonna try and, you know, build in a place, Albuquerque, I don't know where it is, it might be hot, but if there's nobody there, nothing's happened, you're gonna really have to put in a lot of work and effort to build in Albuquerque because there may be not one home event going on there at all. So now I'm just making your life harder for you when you've already got, I mean, San Diego, right? We've already got things built in San Diego. So let me send my guests to a place where it's thriving, where it's hot, and you can sit and find out, you know, just gauge your temperature. Where sort of London, Southeast London is hot right now. That's where pretty much the three Dacosta brothers, we live there. West London, Andre Sinclair. You're gonna see where the flies come up. Birmingham right now is gonna start becoming hot with a weekly meeting. So you wanna go where it's hot. Now, know your time zones. You've got to know your time zones. If you want to build an international business, know your time zones. You see, you may mess around and, you know, call on Skype a prospect or call their mobile phone, like, hey, oh my days, Dwayne, bow, wow, we got it. The weekly meeting, I found a flight, it's right down the road from you. This is gonna be the biggest thing. You need to be there. Oh my days. Let me know when you get there. You're gonna meet this guy called David Acosta. He's a freestyle director. He's in your country. He's gonna help you build this business. Hey man, it's 4 in the morning. 4 in the morning, man. Sleepy man. Oh, sorry. And you ain't ever gonna have them again. All their sleep. So it's important to understand your time zones. When can I talk to my international business partners and prospects? See, on my mobile phone, I have a Samsung, which is much better than an iPhone. I have different time zones. So while I'm in the UK, I already know, okay, I know there's certain times I wouldn't send you a message because he's sleeping. And I don't want to upset him, he's my favorite guy. So, and I know when he's awake, because my phone will tell me, okay, 5 hours back, and now's the time I can send a message, we can do a call. And am I willing to make the time sacrifice? I believe it's a bit harder for us in the UK, because we got to stay up late. So for example, when you guys have your power hour at 8 p.m. or 9 p.m. if Donald Bradley does a call, because I love building international business, I want to know the state of affairs in USA, I'm awake 2-3 in the morning, right? If I'm trying to, you know, do a three-way call, me and Ricardo are doing three-way calls all the time. Ricardo, watch out for this guy here, Ricardo. Hungry, heart of a lion. This guy is building in every single state that I can pronounce. And me and him 4-5 in the morning, Ricardo, is the call gone? Hey, how's it going, sir? Yeah, David Acosta, I'm so excited. Ever fallen asleep on a freeway call? The person didn't sign up, right? So, I mean, building in different places, are you willing to make the time sacrifice? Are you willing to, for you guys, I believe, for you guys, it will be waking up a bit earlier. Obviously, you guys are, and from the UK, you guys are 5 hours back. So, to speak to somebody maybe before they, you know, get up for work or on their lunch break, which is maybe like 12, you might need to be waking up, you know, 7 a.m. for that call with that right person. Is it worth it? Is it worth me waking up 6, 7 a.m. when I've got a long day ahead to speak to somebody in London, England? You just don't know. That person may be like, nah, I'm on my lunch break, but now this, who are you, rabbi? Or that person may be Andre Sinclair, on-site director. You just don't know. But are you willing to make that time sacrifice? For me, I definitely am. I've been awake. If I'm doing a training call with someone or speaking to James Farr and the team, trying to find out, you know, things going on, waking up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in the morning to get things done, are you willing to make that time sacrifice? Now, there's another thing. Run a green business. We're talking about building international. How do I run a green business? What do I mean by run a green business? I mean, you know, just, If this was a company, you'd want to run a green company. You're not spending too much money on petrol. You're not doing things that are obviously not very, you know, very good for in terms of, let me just check the time. been good for, you know, just, you know, spending and doing things that didn't need to be done, right? So when I talk about running a green business, I mean, yes, traveling the world is fun, but don't only build in other countries when you are there in person. Use leverage. For example, I went to Jamaica with Eileen Ross to do the first event there. Now, the next time, I didn't go. Just Eileen went by herself. Now, just because I'm not there, does that mean I can't leverage Eileen being there? So when you guys, I mean, you guys may want to come to the UK, I hope many of you come to convention, but when you're not there, leverage what's already going on there. Find places that you want to go to, but you can also leverage with other people. But when you do travel, make sure your team leverage you. So when I do go back to Jamaica, which I'll be going back sometime soon, I'm gonna make sure my team leverage me, especially when I'm there on the ground. If I'm not there, oops, sorry, let me put that back there. Make sure people can leverage you when you do travel. Let them know, don't turn up in another country and no one in your team knew. See, I can't wait. I know you're going to come into the UK one day soon. When you do, I know your team are going to know where you are. They're going to be like, you know what? Quick phone calls, messages, voice notes, because Derek's going to be in London, England on the 17th. So we leverage it. They're working green now because they're not there. Maybe they haven't got the funds, the $2,000, $3,000 to be in the UK for a week, but they're going to leverage their business partner. So, top three tips to build international. Right? My top three tips. Do the 7 day rule. Do not go more than 7 days without talking to your international business partners, even if they are very successful and independent. So I'm gonna make a public apology right here, right now. Derek, we have gone more than 7 days without speaking, and this is me publicly apologizing to you, right? Because you are very independent and successful, but that's not a reason to say, oh, I've got a Derek, one of the top recruiters in the company. I mean, this guy is a beast, an absolute beast. But that doesn't mean, oh, he's doing so well, I see him in my back office popping up, recruiting. That doesn't mean you just leave them, right? You just don't know what's going on with that person. And the next time you call him, hey, you just hit 4-star, you must be so happy, I'm about to quit. What, really, what? You just don't know what's going on. You just don't know. So the 7 day rule, especially when you've got an international business partners, and many of you will now be getting business partners in the UK, the 7 day rule, make sure, even if it's just say, hey, how's things going? How's the cat? How's your mom? How's, you know, it doesn't have to always be about the matrix and building a business, just keep it in contact, building that relationship. Number two, help international business partners feel included. Very important. Even though they don't live down the road, they are still part of the family. Very important, because if they feel that, if they want to get into the business and you don't really, you know, treat them with any sort of care and love, the way they can slip out of the business, then you're not gonna know. So they find it very easy to slip out of that matrix, right? Because you don't even know anyway, they don't feel special, they don't feel like they're part of the family anyway. You've got this London team going over here, or you've got this Atlanta team going over here, and I'm not really part of it because I don't live in Atlanta or I don't live in London. When sending out online training or team calls, consider mentioning their time zone and local number for international members to take part. For example, your team is in Atlanta, your main team is in Atlanta, and you've got maybe one or two business partners in London, England. When you send out your team calls, your webinars, find out the time zone, put it on there, and they may not be able to get on because it may be a crazy time, but you thought of them. And they understand that, you know, this is also for me as well, because I see my country's time zone here as well, and I feel included. And that's something that Andre Sinclair is very good at. When he's sending out these messages to the team, he makes sure that the other time zones are on there. Now, I should have done my work. So, freeconferencecall.com, I mean, some of you already know it. That might be the wrong address, but go online and I'm going to send you to my Planet website. Everybody join, yeah. Do the research, freeconferencecall.com, where you can find a conference call, and it will have a US number, it will have a UK number, maybe even a Jamaican number. I mean, if you're willing to invest a bit, you can have a number that you can send out. I'm doing a call to my whole team, and anybody from other countries can get in. And again, some of them may be free, some of them may be online and free, some of them may have an investment needed. But if you want to build an international business, and then thousands of dollars or pounds, euros, yens, and all the other currencies as we start to grow, some is going to need a bit of an investment. Award and recognition, very important. When you are doing award and recognition, make sure that your business partners in outside feel very special. I mean, I'm gonna show you an example right now. We had a big Christmas dinner, and we had award and recognition night. and you know, giving out trophies to you know to gold builders and the bronze and silvers, directors and training, the MVPs, and I think I've got a quick video.
Creating evidence that people are winning with Planet Martin, and we have a set of very, very unique special awards to recognize a few individuals for some what we call outstanding leadership, documentation, and extraordinary work ethic to get the job done.
Everyone from Ohio, so happy to have received this award. I hope you guys have a blast today. Thank you so much, John, Toby, David. You guys rock. Your leadership has been phenomenal. So I will see each and every one of you in April at convention. Have fun. Bye, guys.
Yeah, so basically we had an event and actually had one of our business partners, Savannah, who's in Ohio. We had her on a big screen and she, you know, like the Mobos, when Beyonce can't be there because she just don't care. She's busy. She was like, hey guys, sorry I couldn't be there, but my voice is a bit crooky. And thank you so much for being there for me. Jay-Z's taking the award on my behalf. And, you know, which we'll do, she'll make a little video on a big screen. So we had her having a video on a big screen. So she was in the room with us. She felt included, even though she was in Ohio and we was in Southeast London. So award and recognition is very important to help your business partners feel included. Got this from Donald Bradley. High tech versus high touch. High tech, high touch. High tech is the internet, Facebook, social media, Skype, Zoom, free conference call. High touch is me being able to, and it's the best feeling ever, give my man hair a physical touch, right? That's the best feeling ever. It feels way better that than Zoom, right? Conference calls, texting, and that's the difference. When you start building a high touch relationship with your business partner, it is the most amazing feeling ever. If you can set goals to meet your new international business partners in person, a face-to-face business relationship will always be better than an online relationship. Show them you care. For example, if you set rank goals, you know, you find someone in, let's just say, because the distance from, obviously, let's say Atlanta to Jamaica, maybe it's not as far as Atlanta to London. Maybe it's a $200 flight. Maybe some of you, to get to Jamaica with a new business partner, it's only a $200 flight. It's not a bad investment, especially if that person, you know, has hit the rank of bronze or silver. So you can set a rank goal. Hey, how's it going? You know what? I'm so excited to get you going. When you hit gold builder, when you hit silver builder, I'm actually going to personally fly to Jamaica and do a home event for you of your house. We're going to get everybody around. We're going to do something. Because the income you earn from them hitting, you know, maybe gold builder could actually fund you flying to Jamaica. Now, of course, now, a bit bigger now, and again, obviously, my business partner here, Derek, I mean, is about to hit director and training. And he doesn't need to hit director and training for me to fly to Atlanta, because they got soul food there. But I'm going to be there. I'm going to be there anyway, right? So when you hit director and training, which is 50 people, it's a lot of income pounds that you're earning there. When someone hits director, you have someone hit director and training in the UK, I'm going to fly to London to do a big event with you. We're gonna partner up with David, Andre, and we're gonna, you know, do a big event, and I'm gonna go to at least 2-3 homes, and I'm gonna fly back, and it might cost me, you know, $2,000, it might cost me $3,000. That's an investment. That director training will birth other directors as this grows, I promise you that. Business expense, I don't know about your tax laws as much, but that's a business expense, right? The flight, the hotel, the food. We don't have soul food, we have tea, but it's all a business expense, right? So, guys, thank you so much for your time.